Drew and T are heading to the quiet Norfolk village of Carlton Road, half an hour from Norwich. They're meeting Annabel Anderson, who, with her financial investor husband Ian, their two children, and their dogs, cats, geese, chickens, and turkeys, has lived at the old rectory for around 5 years.
When we bought the house and moved here, we imagined it was going to be our forever home. But life changes, things move on, and my children have grown up. My husband is working in London again, 5 days a week, and so I'm rattling around in really quite a large house.
Ian and Annabel are downsizing to a smaller home and are selling off the fine antiques.
I've got a pretty good idea of what the value is of the pieces here, but I don't know how negotiating with Drew on prices is going to go. I'm not very good at negotiating. I'll probably be a pushover.
Oh, yes. Just say the word proportion as we...
Proportion, proportion, proportion. Windows, windows, Georgian, Georgian, Georgian. Loveliness all over it.
Gorgeous.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Drew, how you doing?
Hello, Drew, I'm Annabel.
Hi. Right. Beautiful. What a lovely space.
You love a bit of Georgian, don't you? After you, yeah?
Thank you.
T, look at this. This is beautiful, Annabel.
Nice.
This room partly sold the house to us.
You wouldn't need to come much further, would you? You
no.
Go. I'll take it.
As you came into the house, you could see that the place was just crammed with quality. It's not going to be cheap, but we can guarantee that it's correct.
There's lots of things in here that I do like the look of. And the Amari pots, are they real ones? They look like they're originals to me.
As far as I know, they are.
Would these be for sale?
They would be, yes.
Amari vases originate in Japan and are named after the port in the far south of the country. From the 17th century, the locally made blue and red porcelain was exported worldwide. This pair of vases date back to the 19th century and could be worth around £1,200.
I sold one last year with a crack in it for a very, very good price. It was older than that one, but those are perfection. Where are we price-wise on them?
Something in the region of 500 for the pair.
I think that's very fair.
OK, good.
Yep.
They're yours. Thank you.
The lamps have the perfect country house look, and Drew's done his first deal. Surrounded by so much country house furniture, this is an unbelievable opportunity for Drew.
When you are in a position to buy items of this quality that have been picked by the best and are in just the right condition, you've just got to bite it, you've just got to do it. You've just got to get your chequebook out and go for it, and that's it. You don't get offered this sort of thing every day. This is a top-notch house call.
You have to be so careful today.
It's not going to happen.
You're so careful.
Never on my shit.
The country house look never comes in and out of fashion. I'm not interested in current trends. Couldn't give a monkey's. I like to just do what I want to do. And right now, English country house really appeals. Lovely.
At the old rectory, cherry picking season is in full swing. And Drew spotted an original Georgian bookcase.
1,200. How far apart are we?
We're not very far apart at all.
We can have a deal?
Yeah.
Deal. Okay. Thank you very much.
And with each new room, there are more exquisite items.
I like the rug.
It's quite unusual because it's got the wild animals in it.
It's lovely. Will 600 buy it?
Yeah, 600 will do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fine, deal. That's yours. Thanks very much.
Mm-hmm. And the country house buys keep coming with a George II mahogany wall mirror.
Yeah, very happy with that.
This is one of the best house calls I've been to, just for the sheer volume of good country house items.
And the hunt isn't over. The next room is an upstairs ensuite, because in grand country homes, even bathrooms house antiques.
That's quite an ensuite you've got there. This really is very, very beautiful. Look at that. That's lovely.
It belonged to my mother's mother. It used to be the drinks cabinet. Now it's the medicine cabinet.
I'm guessing this is on the not for sale list.
It's a potentially for sale.
Really?
Piece, yes.
Right. In the corner is one of the sweetest little pieces of furniture I've seen in an awful long time. It's oddly small, diminutive, but achingly pretty. And you could drop that into any house in Britain, no matter what it was, and it would look good.
This cabinet is made from a chest of drawers and a cupboard, which have been married together. The thin burr walnut veneer dates it to the mid-19th century. It could be worth around £2,000.
It's absolutely lovely. What would you want for it?
I
love it. Absolutely love it.
Give me a number and I can say yes or no.
1,300.
I think I'm on it there. I think I'll get 1,800 for it. Yeah, that's me done at that price. I couldn't pay any more.
1,300. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes.
Others. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great. Absolutely love it. If it ever piece of furniture, I could lick that. It's just
I wouldn't recommend it.
No. I didn't think I'd get the opportunity to buy a piece of furniture like that. If I'm able to buy something like that, I'm always going to have a go at it. I've got to ask, and that's when asking works. So I don't suppose you'd sell it. She goes, yeah, there's a profit in it. But it's just such a wonderful thing to have around. I don't really want to let it go.